what could be more fun than to write about booze and bootleggers and Al Capone and Meyer Lansky and all the rest. Regrettably, it ain't true. None of it's true. Kennedy gave, and I'm sorry, you know, Kennedy supplied his Harvard reunion class with liquor that may or may not have been illegal. He got it because his father was an importer. And when Prohibition came in, you were allowed to take all your liquor and put it in your basement, and his father did. And then some of that got to the Harvard reunion. Aside from that, no, no bootlegging whatsoever. The stories about bootlegging don't begin until the 1970s. When Nixon runs against JFK in 1960, Nixon brings out researchers. He hires researchers all over the country to find every bit of dirt they can about the Kennedy family. And they find plenty of dirt about Joe Kennedy, but no one accuses him of being a bootlegger. It's only in the 1970s when writers are trying to figure out the assassination, and they figure it can't be Oswald. It's got to be the mafia. But why would the mafia go after JFK? And these explanations are put together. And all sorts of retired mafia. Can you retire as a mafia person? Some of, you know, in Miami, in Israel, in Europe, in the Bahamas, they all come out when asked, and they say, oh yeah, Joe Kennedy was a good friend of mine, we did a lot of work. And writers, you know, seeing a good story wouldn't let it go. You know, and I'm reading this stuff, trying to track down every rumor, every story. And, you know, the credible witnesses include Al Capone's piano tuner, who gives an interview in which he says he was tuning the piano when Al and Kennedy met together. They include the ex-wife of a Chicago mobster who says, yeah, my husband was a good friend of Joe Kennedy. They included people who came out of the woodwork to talk to me, including someone in a penitentiary in Canada who insisted that his grand uncle had been killed by Kennedy, who was in partnership with Truman as a bootlegger. Kansas, you know, with, how did bootlegging, you know, where did they get the, you know, the booze into Kansas? None of it made any sense. There was one credible piece of data, one credible, and that was that the Canadian government was great during this whole thing. They didn't give a damn. They supported as much booze as possible coming across the border, as long as the ship was paid an excise tax before they slipped it into the United States. A Joseph Kennedy Limited of Vancouver refused to pay the excise tax. And this, you know, people had said, oh, there's the proof, there's the smoking gun. Well, I found this Kennedy. I looked at the business records and the tax records and the business directories in Vancouver. And I discovered that it's David Joseph Kennedy, who lived in Vancouver, had been born in Vancouver, died in Vancouver, not my Joe Kennedy. So, no bootlegging of any sort.